into that. 14-yard return, a 49-yard kick. So Vince Young has final words on the sideline, and here he comes again. Six plays so far and no first downs for Texas offense. The field position gets a little bit better with each subsequent punt, though, for Texas. Now they work at the 35-yard line. Taylor, the single setback, and Vince will be under center. And the option, Taylor on the corner, across the 40, puts his head down and bounces out of bounds right about at the first down marker. This kid's had an interesting year. Spent most of the time at wide receiver in the spring and in the summer. Bounced back and forth. Now the starter last week at tailback and went over 100 yards and scored 3 touchdowns in the win over Baylor. So he's not only a good running back, but obviously being used as a wide receiver so often, he's dangerous in that department as well.
Dave Thomas, the tight end, had a great block to help spring him on that play.
Picks it up on one hop. Got the corner. Might have a bunch more. Talk about fortuitous hops. That thing could have been a disaster, and it came right back up to him.
You're exactly right, partner.
Into Kansas territory with a run. There's a first down. Finally, we'll move the sticks.
Let's take a look and see if we can see. It looked like Vince had the ball right in there. He looked like Taylor was looking and didn't put his hands down to clamp on the football, but you're right. He had a great break. The ball just popped right back to him.
So first down at the Jayhawk 45. First trip for Texas into Kansas territory. Nice play fake by Vince Young. Might want it all. Going deep. Got Sweet out there. Got it. Touchdown.
Joanna Sweet.
The slow start is over. 45 yards. Vince Young, Joanna Sweet. Touchdown, Texas. Well, it was kind of a jump ball, but he's got a guy almost built like Roy Williams out there wearing Roy's old number at 6'5", and he just went up and got it. David Pino, another of the seniors in for the point after. And it's up and good. Take another look at the touchdown.
And single coverage at the top, inside technique by Baines on the outside. And you're exactly right, partner. He just throws it up. Baines sees it, just can't get up there. Sweet is 6'5", and Baines is 5'11". So Sweet out jumps him, kind of pushes, gets some separation from him, too, a little bit.
Little hand fight.
Little hand fighting going on, but he's 6'5", and he can jump.
But Bob, when we were talking to Young at the meeting yesterday, he was talking about the players around him, the confidence he has in them, and they talk about the confidence they have in Young. It's great when a quarterback knows he can put the ball out there and rely on his receivers to make a play for it. And if he doesn't make the big catch or the big play, they at least knock it down. These are things you can't coach. These are things you can't teach anyone, but these are the things that come with confidence and trust in your teammate over a period of time.
I don't know that I've been around a team, maybe with the exception of USC, that does have as much confidence in each other. You can tell it off the field, on the practice field, and you just saw it, as Swally said, right there with a touchdown. Greg Johnson, a kick. Haggins and Green back deep. Haggins will take it at the 3. Lost the ball twice. Texas got it. They might score. They will. Killenroo, touchdown. They're going to bring it back, I think, to the 10-yard line. And that draws around the booze.
But just the thing that Mangino did not want to happen has happened. That is special teams. He wanted to win the battle on special teams. And now they turn it over.
And there's the guy. Boom, got a hit. Picked it up. And not advanceable, so it comes back to the 10-yard line.
A muff is not advanceable. A fumble is.
And they rule that a muff. Probably a good call. First and goal at the 10. The run inside is to the end zone anyway. Jamal Charles, touchdown. So it only took one play to take advantage of the fumble recovery. In a matter of about 15 seconds, it's gone from scoreless to 14 to nothing if the extra point's good.
In a matter of three plays, the long pass, the sweep, the kickoff, and then the run for the touchdown, Kansas is out of this game. This is exactly what they wanted to do to Texas and not to themselves.
Extra point, up and good. 7:40 remaining in the first quarter, and number two Texas looking like the number two team in the country. 14 to nothing. Slow start with 2-3 and outs, and then they've lit up the scoreboard. And now we'll have to see if Kansas offense can regroup. They've got to get something mustered against the Texas defense, or it's going to be a long, long day in Austin. Welcome those of you that have been watching Oklahoma and Texas A&M. Brad Nessler, Bob Greasy, and Lynn Swan from Austin. And that's Greg Haggins, who just muffed a kickoff return for Kansas moments ago. It was scooped up by Killebrew. It was not advanceable, but just one play later, Jamal Charles took it in for Texas' second touchdown in the last three plays. And what was a scoreless game literally minutes ago is now Texas 14, Kansas nothing. We welcome you to Darrell K. Royal Texas Memorial Stadium, the number two team in the country. The Texas Longhorns try to become a perfect 10. They're 9-0 against a 5-4 Kansas group that's won its last two games and done so with defense. But they've made too many mistakes early here today. They'll finally get some good field position here. Kansas offensively will start from its own 35-yard line. John Saunders showed you the first touchdown, which you may not have seen. We take a look at our game summary. The muff kick, Killebrew took it in. Texas thought they had a touchdown, but they brought it back to the 10-yard line. And one play, Jamal Charles spinning his way into the end zone. That's where we are right now. The other touchdown, as you saw, was Vince Young, 45 yards on a jump ball in the end zone to his tall wide receiver, Lima Sweet. That's where we are right now. Kansas in some serious danger right here as Jason Swanson brings him out. He's become the starter now the last two or three weeks and has really stabilized the Kansas offense. Now he knows he's playing in a deep hole, though, and that's not good on the road. Here's Clark Green. Green and John Cornish almost interchangeable. One's number 30, one's number 29, and they'll use them both a lot today as we take a look at our Crestor starting lineup. Rodriguez, Whitaker, Ochoa, Cantrell, and Thompson, the big guys up front for Kansas. Green, the starter tailback. McAnderson is the fullback. Fine, a good tight end. And Gordon and Simmons, the wide receiver. Simmons, their leading receiver. 34 catches for over 500 yards coming in. At the 40-yard line. Second down and five for the Jayhawks. And whistles will stop play and another penalty down. And Kansas already has been penalized three times in the ball game. Claire Gossman is our referee.
False start, number 85, offense, 5 yards, second down.
That's four penalties already on Kansas. And Mark Mangino in his fourth year hates the sight of that.
And that's just not in this ball game. They've had problems with penalties all years, and The turnover problem has been there all year also. They're 101st in the nation in turnover margin. That was their 24th giveaway of the season.
You don't want to give any gifts to a team as good as Texas. Second down and 10. Swanson with four wideouts. Quick three-step drop through the slant. Incomplete behind his intended receiver. It was Mark Simmons that he was aiming it at. Defensively, for the Texas Longhorns, up front, both their offensive and defensive lines are good ones. Crowder and Okam, Wright and Robinson. Wright, an All-American candidate. The linebackers undersized compared to some years, but they love to play football. Killebrew, Harris, and Babineau. And in the secondary, guys that have made a lot of starts back there and have played a lot together, especially Griffin and Huff. Terrell Brown and Cedric Griffin are the corners.
Well, the strength of that defense is probably the defensive line and that secondary. Here they come.
Option, maybe the right call if they can get to the corner, but the pursuit is just too strong and too fast. Larry Dibbles made the first hit.
And he says, don't try that stuff around here. He said, I had my safeties were blitzing up the middle, so I was coming to the outside. And don't take that stuff where I'm going. Dibbles is 92. He's a defensive tackle. And when the running back cuts back, Dibbles is there.
Dibbles, not even a starter, was last year, but part of a eight-man rotation. They're all good ones on that defensive line. Aaron Ross set to return Kyle Tucker's punt. Third three and out for Kansas. Nice kick and fair catch call for it. He'd like to have that one back. He's rolling his eyes right now. 46-yard punt. So Vince Young has already thrown one touchdown pass today. And the big junior at 6'5", a Heisman candidate, will get another crack with the offense of the Longhorns when we come back. Brad Nessler, Bob Greasy, Lynn Swan in Austin. Texas, two series, three and out at the beginning, and then boom, Vince Young.
Kansas was doing well on the road where they don't play well until the kickoff, the fumble, the big play. Three plays within a matter of 15, 20 right. seconds, and now they're down.
This isn't the kind of Kansas offense that's going to rebound right away, you would think.
They don't come back that well. They're going to need some turnovers of their own.
Fifteen total yards away from being the school career leader. He's still got a whole other season to play here in Austin. Here's Ramontz Taylor. A lot of dancing, and all it got him was about a five-yard loss. Vince, his numbers on the season, 63%, much more accurate than the past couple of years. Eight touchdowns on the ground, 26-2 as a starter. That's the important part. He didn't really care about stats, he'll tell you that. Doesn't mind piling a few up, but that's not the important part. And the chemistry of this team, Greg Davis was telling us yesterday in his 33 years of coaching, he's never seen more chemistry on one football team. Offensively, defensively, special teams, the whole package. The throw is to Thomas, the senior. He's got a big gainer. The tight end out to the 45. David, a senior out of Wolfhard, Texas, playing his final game here at home. Let's take a look at the Presto starting lineups. Here's the big eaters up front. Scott and Studdard and Sendline. All their daddies played, and they're heck of a players too. Allen and Blaylock round out the front five. Taylor starting at tailback. We'll see three today, though. Ahmad Hall, the fullback. Thomas, we just saw him with a big catch, in Pittman and Sweet are the two starting wide receivers, and they go to three and four wide receiver packages much of the time as they do here. Young, plenty of time trying to, thinking about sidearming it over the middle. Instead, he takes off, flags down. If that run was to stand, he'd be the total offense career leader, but I think it's coming back on a holding call.
I think they're going to take it away from him, but I think he'll eventually get it back.
Yeah, I think so too.
Holding 73, offense 10 yards, previous spot, first down.
Jonathan Scott, the guilty party. Ashley and Keith, Some really good defensive ends that can bring some pressure for Kansas. Allen and McClinton are the inside guys. The linebackers, Bob talked about them earlier, Reed and Kane and Floodman. They've all been around a long time. They're all defensive captains. The secondary, Baines and Tlaib on the corner, and Kemp and Fowler are the safeties.
This Kansas team, this is the best scoring defense in 24 years at Kansas. And this group is really impressive. They really get off the ball, get in the backfield, and make things happen.
Dalton Keith, you're seeing there, 18 tackles for loss, fourth in the conference with 8 sacks, and he almost had an interception earlier in the ball game on a batted ball. Young's going to go deep. Cosby's out there, flags are down. It's going to be interference, but he's got the ball and a touchdown, Texas. 64 yards. These passes are not things of beauty from Vince Young, but his receivers are making him look awful good right now.
That's just what I was going to say. I mean, it's just, they're throwing him up for grabs, and not necessarily that, but he's doing the right thing, because like Swanee said earlier, at worst, his receivers are going to fight to knock the ball down, not let it get picked off. But they're doing one better by catching it and running it into the end zone.
That was some kind of grab by the former center fielder. That's what it looked like he was doing there, because he wrestled that ball away in what would have been a pass interference call, and instead it's a 64-yard touchdown. Hito in for the point after. All Texas right now. Still 4:37 to go in the first quarter. They look like they're the number two team in the country. Maybe better. 4:38 in the first. It's 21 to nothing, Horns. Fans are getting it. They're getting their money's worth right now. 80,000 of them all dressed in burnt orange. Here on ABC, they lead 21 to nothing. Greg Johnson's been a busy kicker. High and short this time. Green's going to run up on it at the 10-yard line. Oh, didn't get to the 20. Ran into a buzzsaw named Matt Melton on the special teams. So Kansas trailing 21 to nothing. Offensively, they got to try to get something going against Mack Brown's Longhorns. We'll see if they do when we come back. You know, some coaches just drool over the way Texas looks sometimes. Bevo 14 does the same. His team is in front 21 to nothing. Swanson on a handoff to Cornish. And Cornish maybe got a yard. That's about it. Larry Dibbles again helped out on the stop defensively along with Robinson.
Kansas, this is their fourth possession. They've had 9 plays. They've run 9 plays for 9 yards. Each of the first 3 possessions were 3 plays and a punt.
And Texas has 21 points on the board despite only having 2 plays run in Kansas territory. They did it from long range, and then on the muffed kick, they did it in 1 play from the 10. Find the tight end to be in motion. Play clock. I guess they got it off. It was close. Quick throw. Ball is loose. And I think they're going to spot it back out at the 25-yard line. Swanee.
Brad, you know, during pregame warm-up, I was watching Kansas and watching the offense work and standing behind Swanson. And Mark Mangino came over, and he's talking to his offense as they were executing. He said, hey, guys, just remember, we want to be patient. We want to take our time. We don't want to be in a hurry. We want to get short passes. We want to take the short runs, try and possess this football as much as possible, because the overall game plan has to be keeping it out of the hands of the offense of Texas, so Vince Young and company can't put up a lot of points.
And already with 2 touchdown passes, Vince has put up big points. Swanson, throws. Would have been a tough catch for Fine. He had it in his hands and couldn't hold it, and Kansas will have to give it up again.
Yeah, it was open. If Swanson could have gotten the ball out in front of him, Fine had a step. The Texas defense was in a blitz situation, so had a lot of one-on-one situations in the secondary.
Most of Swanson's passes have been behind his intended receivers so far. Kyle Tucker is coming in to punt again. Aaron Ross back deep, already 3 punts in the first quarter. You don't want your punter to be that busy. Last time, Ross fair caught the ball when As soon as he did, he knew he had plenty of room in front of him. Nice kick. Flags are down at the line of scrimmage. Ross will field it at the 16. Got by the first wave again. And goes out of bounds after about a 15-yard return. But again, penalty markers back at the line of scrimmage. A holding call on Kansas. And I would think Texas is going to make him kick again because that was a heck of a punt. David Thomas out there, and Mac Brown is giving the sign saying take the penalty.
Thank you. Holding number 45, offense, 10 yards previous spot, fourth down.
So that's going to back it up inside the 20 is where they'll be punting from the next time. Mac Brown in his eighth year in Texas and looking for his 80th victory as the head man of the Longhorns. 42-3 on this field in his 8 years here. That's not too bad.
It's his 22nd year as a head coach in college. He spent 10 years at North Carolina and then the 3 years at Tulane.
He's on a lot of Coach of the Year semifinalist lists. A perfect season is a possibility. Now Tucker's near his own goal line. Let's see if Texas comes after it. The snap's a little high, but they've got the return on, and he got another dandy of a punt. Way back goes Ross to the 29. And across the 40, Ross in the clear.
Look out.
The punter to beat. Ross at the 20. He is gone. Touchdown. That's why you make him kick it again. 71-yard punt return for a score. The wheels are falling off the Jayhawk wagon right now, and there's still 2.5 to go in the quarter.
Well, that's two special team touchdowns in the first quarter for Texas.
A happy coach and a happy return guy. Dino in for the point after. A junior out of Tyler, Texas. There's been some pretty good football players come out of Tyler, Texas.
This is his second punt return for a touchdown this year.
A lot of weaving and then got the clear and turned on the speed. 28-0, Texas. Johnson to kick. Gary Green at about the 3. And he can't find the 20-yard line. The special teams of Texas are just eating things up too right now. John's got an ACC update in New York. Let's check in. John, thank you.
Kicking team, 5-yard penalty, re-kick.
So we'll have our second re-kick, one on a punt earlier on a holding call, now an offside against Texas to try to give Kansas a little better field position.
John, say Florida State got beat again?
Well, they were getting beat by Clemson the last time I saw, and I think that's what he was alluding to. I know Lee Corso at game day this morning said he thought that Florida State would lose out the rest of their games.
That, you know, and that, you know what he was thinking of? He was thinking of losing, FSU losing at Clemson. They've got Florida next week, and then they've got the Miami probably in the ACC championship game. It could happen.
Take a look at our drive summary presented by Drive Insurance from Progressive. Texas, that looks pretty good, doesn't it? That is their 16th 80-yard plus touchdown march this year. And that only took 3 plays.
Look at that.
7 plays, 3 touchdowns, and two of them long range. I don't know if they're going to run out of ammo on that cannon over there in the end zone. I hope they brought a whole box.
Thompson. I hope they didn't.
Oh, man. What a shot at the 22-yard line he took from Ryan Palmer.
Every time they fire that cannon over there, I jump about 3 feet.
They've been busy, I'll tell you that much. Watch this collision. Whoa, man.
Well, you know, what we're seeing is a dominant team here in the first quarter on all phases. The special teams, the coverage teams for Texas have been outstanding. The return teams have been good. Their offense and defense is excellent. So what are we thinking here? They're number two in the nation. You know, this is like a pretty good matchup with USC. If everybody just waits and, you know, in December or January, we'll see these two teams meet.
Now Kansas trailing 28 to nothing. 2:19 left in the first quarter. And again, whistles will stop play.
Delay of game. Offense, 5 yards, first down.
Boy, you can't have a delay of game after a kick return. Is there anything worse?
Yeah, you're exactly right. And this is part of the reason right here on the road and the giveaways. They don't play as well on the road, and that's for a lot of different reasons. Most teams don't play as well on the road, but they play well at home. They beat the last 2 weeks. They had Missouri, their arch rival. They beat them, and then Nebraska, after 36 times, they beat them.
There's a little swing out to Gordon. Gordon, big blow delivered out there by Terrell Brown and Michael Huff. They do a little John when it's all over. Right now, Texas is exploding and Kansas is imploding, and that's not a good combination.
Yeah, if you're in that offensive huddle with the blue team and you're Swanson in the quarterback, you got to say, hey, let's just go down and score one touchdown. Let's just get one. You know, don't forget forget about the score. Let's just move it down, pick up some first downs, and make some plays and go down and get one score.
Let's see if they can get a first down here on 2nd and 10. Here comes a blitz, option, pitch out to Gordon. Only got to the line of scrimmage again. That's about it. Derek Loki and Terrell Brown out to make the stop for Texas. Texas not only talented defensively, deep defensively. That's something you don't usually find. Sometimes your frontline guys are pretty good and the guys behind them aren't, and that's not the case here.
Well, as you mentioned, they play 8 guys up front. Loki is the backup for Rod Wright, one of the All-American defensive tackles on this ball club. They've got a lot of players and a lot of talent and a big pool to choose from. I mean, Texas is a big state. Mac was saying there's what, 320 Division I players come out every year. All we want to get is like 25 of them.
And a lot of them, of those 25, want to come here because it's kind of the place to be. Awfully nice town, capital. They love their Longhorns in this stadium, and they're giving them a standing ovation right now.
Well, Bob Pratt, Texas is not the only school around the country that's aware of that. Kansas comes into Texas to recruit quite a bit also. Matter of fact, on this Kansas roster, they've got 28 kids from the state of Kansas, but they have 23 who are from Texas.
It is a talent-rich place for high school football. Kyle Tucker and Aaron Ross took his last one that he kicked to him 71 yards the other way. Sure, Tucker's aware of that, but he just knocks it straight down the middle again. Way back to the 18-yard line goes Ross, and this time they bring him down. Nice job on the special teams. John Cornish got down there and made the stop, no return. Coming up tomorrow night, go against Donovan McNabb minus Terrell Owens. Nice throw by Vince Young to Nate Jones for a first down.
We were out watching practice the other day and just watching Vince Young and run this offense of Texas through its paces. He's a fourth year junior. I'm talking about Vince. He's 6'5 and weighs about 235 pounds. And I saw him a couple of years ago, and we've seen him through the years. And it's amazing the way he's just gotten better and better and better. And now it's just like so nonchalant, and it's not that easy. But his accuracy has improved, his footwork has improved. The game has really slowed down for him, and he just seems to be in control. And there is no question that he is the leader of this game.
Yep, no doubt. And they look up to him figuratively and literally sometimes. And you can see him. He's got everybody's attention. And they say, you know what? He can dance around in between plays and even on the field during a game. But when he gets in the huddle, he's all business. He's been all business in the first quarter. And it's been all Texas. 28 to nothing. The Longhorns, the number 2 team in the country. Our presentation of college football continues after this message and a word from our ABC stations. You're watching ABC Sports, Championship Television.
Board the Bevo bus outside Darrell K. Royal Texas Memorial Stadium in Austin. I'll make a prediction. Bevo will never get off his big butt if Kansas doesn't do something in this game pretty soon. He's been laying down, unless he goes to graze somewhere else.
I bet he doesn't get up unless somebody comes and yanks on his chain.
End around. Ramontz Taylor in the open field. Out across the 35. Looks like he's going to have a first down. Kevin Kane made the stop. Career total offense, the leader now, having overtaken Major Applewhite, is Vince Young, 8,153 yards.
You know the scary thing about all that is?
He's got a year and something to go.
He's got another year to go. And he has said repeatedly that he is going to come back for his fifth year.
He's been asked so many times, and he's handled all those questions perfectly, including the ones about the Heisman Trophy and everything else. Here he is off play action. Plenty of time, patiently pulls it down now, puts a move on, and gets out of bounds after he got about 5 yards. Nick Reed ran him out of bounds, the linebacker.
And I think the atmosphere around this place is such that the guys don't want to leave early. I don't think Mac has had anybody that has left early that still had eligibility to go at the University of Texas. It really is a family atmosphere that Mac has created.
Mac and Sally, his wife, big part of it, and a huge part of the community. Here's Charles in the open field. Jamal Charles, he's all the way down inside the Kansas 40 to the 37. 20-yard run. Remember, he had a touchdown run of 10 yards earlier in the ballgame.
One of the things that has been talked about around here is maybe Texas won't have a 1,000-yard rusher this year for the first time in the last, 10 years.
Yeah.
Charles came in with about 700 yards, and actually Vince Young, the quarterback, had
78
yards. So Vince could get it before Charles does.
Vince had a 1,000-yard season 2 years ago on the ground.
That was back when he didn't know what he was doing throwing the ball.
Actually, 2 years ago, he's a little bit short. Last year is when he had 1,079 and 14 rushing touchdowns. So he's a dual threat.
That was when he had to take it down and run because he didn't read the coverages right.
Yep.
Now I think he's a better quarterback, reading coverages, knowing what to do with the ball, and he's not having to run as much.
Of course, he just took over the Rose Bowl and the win over Michigan. Running and throwing, and the MVP, and we talked to him yesterday. All of the Texas players, for the most part, have said, we've been aiming toward Houston. They want to be in the Big 12 championship game because since the BCS has come into play, they've never won the Big 12 title in that big game that'll match North and South. But yesterday, admittedly, with all his teammates around him, Vince Young looked at us and kind of winked, and he said, I don't see any flowers in here, but I'm almost getting a whiff of roses. So they know what's down the road if they just keep doing their business.
Well, this summer when they were all working out, they were talking Big 12. We'll win the Big 12. We'll win the Big 12. And then after that, everything takes care of itself.
And that's what they're looking at, some burnt orange roses in Pasadena, maybe against USC. That's the dream matchup that everybody has been talking about really since the beginning of the season. And so far, neither team has disappointed. Cal and USC playing right now. We'll keep you abreast of those scores, or John will. Here's a little counter. And again, it didn't look like there was any room for Jamal Charles, but that whole wave just kept moving, and he finally found a little crease and got 8 more yards. Nice job of just walling off the Kansas defenders, not getting any penetration, and he gets a good gain out of it. Near the conclusion of our game today, we'll select a Chevrolet player of the game. Chevrolet will make a $1,000 contribution to each university's general scholarship fund. Texas with a 28-point lead and a first down at the 23-yard line of Kansas. And Vince Young has hit his last 7 passes to, what, 5 different receivers? See if he can make it 8 in a row to the end zone. In and out of the hands of Swede's hands, but there's going to be pass interference, it appears, on Aqib Talib. It was a pretty well-thrown ball.
Well-designed pass, too, Brad. They had 2 post routes, one going across and the flanker going deep into the middle.
Pass interference, number 28 defense, 15 yards, automatic first down.
Take a look up here. The top receiver just going to go down and run a post. The shorter receiver's running across the field.
And he basically gets him all over the legs to take away that little extra jumper. He maybe would have caught that for the touchdown.
He just hit him just a tad early.
So now on the ninth play of the Texas drive, they're inside the Kansas 10-yard line. First and goal. With the sun coming out in Austin, Ramontz Taylor might make it shine even brighter. Touchdown! Looking pretty easy for the Longhorns right now. Taylor and Pittman, two tight teammates. They call each other cousins, even though they're not related, but they're best friends. They got a little bump over there on the sideline in celebration of another touchdown. 8-yard touchdown run. Keno going after up a good. So Ramontz, who had three rushing touchdowns last week, he didn't do the dive into the end zone. He didn't have time. He told me yesterday probably won't be diving for a while. He had to work for that one. 35-0 Texas. Texas 35, Kansas nothing. We still got 12 minutes plus remaining in the second quarter. Happy Longhorn fans here in Austin today. With Bob Parisi and Lynn Swann, I'm Brad Nessler. That's Ramontz Taylor. Staying warm after his touchdown run. Greg Johnson's kick fielded 4 yards deep by Thompson, and Kansas will have to work from the 20-yard line. Well, we know what number two is doing. What's number one doing, Johnson? All right, John, thanks. Cal's played him so well, really, the last 3 years, but USC well aware of that. After this play, we'll talk about the BCS a little bit, look at the standings. Kansas, 21 yards of total offense and 20 yards in penalties. Not a good combination. Got a man wide open here, though, and not enough real estate. Or did he catch it?
No, he's out of bounds.
Let's take a look at, I think the linesman's going to give him that.
Well, the back judge was waving way out of bounds.
I was looking at the linesman. You were looking at the back judge.
I was looking at this guy here.
Well, I think he's out of bounds, isn't he? Boy, I mean, what a great effort. I don't know.
The effort is great. Whether the toe is in.
I mean, I don't know if those are size 11s or 10 and a halfs. And they're going to say first down. All right. Well, the effort was unbelievable, and I'm glad they gave him the catch.
That's good. That's the first. That's the first down.
They just showed the replay up here on the big board.
Let's see.
They're going to have to.
Looks like his toe is on the line. The Texas coaches are right there.
And the play will be under review as co-defensive coordinator Dwayne Aquino. He's the guy that's yelling a little bit louder than Mac Brown is. Mac meets the officials. Dwayne backs up a little bit.
If you think this is overkill, and some of you out there watching, Texas had 35-0.
Right, exactly.
They want to not give them a play. These defensive coaches, they don't think that way.
No. Absolutely not. So they'll talk things over with the group upstairs. Our replay official, Richard Wittenberg, today. So he's big play.
Receiver was ruled out of bounds. First down, first and 10.
So they're going to bring it all back.
He said first and 10?
So I thought he meant back to the original line of scrimmage.
Yeah.
They're going to back it up. It'll be first down. Well, wait a minute. It's either got to be second down.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Second down and 10.
He said first and first down.
He meant second and 10.
Exactly. I think.
Now they got to get all straight. They still haven't moved the chains either on the far side of the field. They're still set up at the 42. Now they're going to jog it back. A meeting of the minds and the chains and the head coach of Kansas, too.
I wonder, I don't want to say it, if there's any talk about.
about any sort of favoritism towards Texas because they're number two in the BCS.
Well, you know,
that came up last year.
That came up last year. That's right. And when I saw Mark over there talking to the officials, I remember seeing that clip of how upset he was after the ball game last year when he was talking about maybe a ruling on the field that didn't go his way.
So second down to 10 after all that wasted time, but definitely not a wasted effort by the wide receiver. Here comes a blitz. Tips caught, and it's going to be a loss. Maybe should have let that one tip and dropped. We take you back to last year, what we were talking about, a 27-23. That was his comments after Charles Gordon was called for offensive pass interference on a play that, had it been upheld and been a completion, conceivably Kansas could have gone down, either scored or at least kept possession and kept the ball away from Texas and won the ball game.
Yeah. That is the, what is that? That's the seventh possession and the sixth time they've gone three plays and out. The other time was the kickoff where they fumbled it over to Texas.
And so Tucker again will have to punt from his own goal line, and Ross has already taken one for a touchdown today, long distance. They haven't come close to blocking a punt yet, but they really have had the return on most of the day. Not a good kick this time off the side of his foot, and takes a Texas bounce right away. And it's going to be Texas starting in Kansas territory again at the 47-yard line. Only a 32-yard kick. Time now for our Aflac trivia question. What former Jayhawk or Longhorn is credited with inventing the football helmet? It wasn't that guy, I don't think. Although he might be credited with putting horns on a leather
helmet. Yeah, I like the horn.
Yeah, that's good.
Well, I could have used that on my helmet on a few of those quarterback sneaks.
He's got everything going on. I want to party with that guy. So we'll give you the answer a little bit later on.
They look like Vikings.
At the 47-yard line. Salvin Young in with Vince Young in the backfield. Low snap. Vince has to go down and snatch it up and buys himself some time. And tiptoes out of bounds. Even right there, you saw he's always just patient.
He never gets rattled. He never gets nervous or jumpy. You know, the unexpected doesn't bother him. He says, oh, I'm going to reach in, pick this up, and I'm still going to try and make something out of this. Snap was low.
Hit it right in the ankle.
It's a shin. He steps up there like a hot potato and picks it up.
So second down, he got a yard out of it. 2 yards, actually. Second down and 8. Hand off. Try to get to the corner is Charles. Excuse me, it's Salvin Young. Salvin Young, a great run, 17 yards. Young has been a little bit banged up, but they still put him in there on all third down situations because he's so great at blitz pickup, and he's got good hands on the backfield. He shows his running ability right here.
Talk about the depth of Texas in some of these positions. We've talked about the offensive defensive line. Salvin Young is the third guy in there today because you said he's injured. Jamal Charles, the outstanding true freshman, and Romance Taylor, the other two guys that have been in there, they're explosive, exciting backs. Now you've got Salvin Young, another guy. They've got more depth than most teams have good players.
Young going deep, Scott Thomas down the seam, touchdown. David Thomas, a tight end, 29 yards, another Longhorn score. That's Vince Young's third touchdown pass of the day. ...10-19 remaining in the half, and soon to be 42-0 Texas. David Pino in for the point after. And it's up and good. Get out of the way.
It's good.
They're using a lot of ammo over there today.
10-19 remaining in the half. A red-hot Vince Young and his supporting cast ain't bad either.
Let's go back to that previous play. Thomas is right here, the tight end. He's going to go right down the middle. Watch the defensive man. He's going to play free safety in the center. Tight end goes straight down the middle. Look at him, wide open. Got all that room to run. Good throw by the quarterback. Now he just runs over. He sees the end zone, and he says, I want a touchdown, and he gets in. That's his 14th touchdown pass of his career.
Kickoff again in the end zone, about 4 yards deep, and again, Thomas Thompson doesn't bring it out. 20-yard line for Kansas. Let's check in with Swanee.
Oh, Bob Bookman College. And guys, as we watch this play, Major, can you tell me what it means to you when you come here on an afternoon like this, a flyover, and to have the respect and the appreciation of this crowd?
Yes, sir. Especially on Veterans Day holiday, it's great to come out and show the flag and to hear the enthusiasm that we had whenever we did the flyover. We could hear the applause over the radio, and it sounded pretty thunderous.
Oh, you could hear it over the radio?
You could hear it over the radio.
Now, from up there, what does it look like? How does it feel? Because you're actually going pretty slow for an F-18.
And we wanted to make sure everybody got a good look at us. So it looked like a sea of burnt orange is what it looked like, and it looks like that from the stadium, too.
Well, you are much appreciated. Thank you for taking the time. Enjoy the rest of the afternoon.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
Brett?
Thanks, fellas. That was something. That just gives you chills. Now, speaking of chills, Jason Swanson's got some right now as Killebrew just hit him head on. That flyover right at the end of the national anthem. And not only the seniors were they introduced today, but Matt Nordgren is a senior quarterback who has not played much because of Vince Young's presence. He was elected one of the team captains today to bring out the American flag when the horns came out of the tunnel over there. And not only that, but another one of the guys that was introduced very early was Ahmad Hall, and he was in the Marines in Afghanistan. There's Matt. And when he was told that he would be the guy to bring out the flag after practice the other day, Mac Brown said, a lot of tears in his eyes. Nine minutes remaining here, 42-0. Let's check in on USC again. Here's John. So much made of how talented Reggie Bush is and how phenomenal Vince Young is. That lineup guy's not bad either.
Yeah, that's what the guard defense would say. Oh, swell. Now he can run for touchdowns, too.
Yeah, great. Watson's pass incomplete. We talked about number one and number two. Take a look at the BCS standings presented by All States. We look in on Texas Memorial Stadium. USC and Texas, the top two. Alabama, we understand, is up 10-0 with LSU. Miami's worked its way back in there. Penn State's got a big game left. Virginia Tech falling out after the loss to Miami out of the top five. LSU still with hope if they can beat Alabama. Georgia's got a big game tonight against Auburn between the hedges. Ohio State routed Northwestern today. And Oregon there in the top 10 as well.
A lot of big games next week.
Tucker's been a busy punter. This is a good one again. But he'll keep it at least out of the hands of Aaron Ross because it went out of bounds at about the 19-yard line. Timeout with 8:18 remaining in the Lone Star State here in Austin. Number 10 has looked like a perfect 10 so far in this first half. Florists that got empty windows, I think, on this Saturday in Austin, Texas. A lot of roses in this building.
Uh-huh.
And then there's Santa, who's already preparing. It's not that far away.
He's incognito.
He is. Okay. Cap threw me off. First down at the 24.
A lot of big men in this building today. Uh-huh.
Vince Young all day to throw. Ramon's Taylor's out there. Just overshot him or it would have been a touchdown.
That was a play we saw him working on the other day. And every time we saw it, he was open. He just overthrew it.
They don't overthrow many. Look at the last five possessions. Texas has scored, if you go back to the Oklahoma State game where they trailed at halftime and had to come out of the blocks in the second half and put the pedal to the metal. They've scored 142 unanswered points in the last little over 2 weeks. 42-0 here after a 62-0 win over Baylor last week. And
they're not done. Here's a little shovel pass inside. Kansas defends it well. Only a pickup of about a yard. Floodman made the tackle.
Well, they're not holding back any. That play, a little fake and then pass to the halfback, sneaking down the sideline. I mean, that's, you don't just run that against everybody. So that was something they put in for the ball game. These shovel passes, the screens.
There's Matt Norgren.
There's
the guy
Norgren. He is the backup quarterback. He is a fifth-year senior, has not played a lot. In fact, he's only thrown 8 passes this season.
You wonder in the second half, though, if we'll see Vince Young.
There aren't many weaknesses on this Texas team.
Blitz. He picks up the fumbled snap again and completes it out the sweep. Just like that, again, he just calmly bends over, picks up the ball, and then flings it out there for 15 yards and a first down.
I mean, the offense is strong, the defense is strong. The return teams, both the punt and the kickoff teams, are in the top 10 in the nation.
Again, bad snap.
It's the second time that snap puts the backup center, Griffin, in there. Just flips it out. But if there is a weakness or an unproven spot, if anything should happen to Vince Young, if anything should happen to Vince Young, Norgren has not played that much. In fact, like I said, he's only 4 of 8 passes and no touchdown, so he'd have to come in and play. It'd be an entirely different package that they would run with Norgren.
Trying to go to Thomas's tight end, and he threw it over everybody there. Incomplete.
First, you don't want to see anything happen to Vince. You don't want to see anything happen to Matt Leinart. You'd like to see these two guys keep these powerhouses going and meet in that championship game in the Rose Bowl.
Well, Texas doesn't have that much left in the way. Texas A&M has fallen on a tremendous amount of injuries, and they play them Thanksgiving weekend on ABC. And then the Big 12 championship game at Reliant Stadium in Houston against either Colorado or Iowa State. Those two are playing tonight. Here's Charles again. Boy, he's got a lot of wiggle to him, doesn't he? He finds a little crease, and he finds a way to get through it.
As we said, he's a true freshman. He came in here. He was one of the top players coming out of Texas. And they seem to get a lot of these top players in Texas. And that's why they're so good. In the offensive line, the defensive line, the running back position, the wide receivers. I mean, Texas gets a lot of the best players in the best state for players in the country.
52 yards already for Jamal on only 5 carries. Taylor back in there for him. Young comes up throwing. And a low pass, but completed to Gatewood. And that's going to be down near the 40-yard line.
And you say, all right, isn't 42 enough? You know, when are they going to call Vince off? Well, he's got to get his work. I mean, they've beaten a lot of teams by a lot of scores. They've scored 48 or more points in 8 of their 9 ball games. So, but he still has to get his timing. He's still got his thing in the ball games.
Their lowest scoring game was their win in Columbus on ABC over Ohio State. And then 7 straight of 40-plus, 62 last week, 42 in the first half this week.
They had 5 games where they've scored in the 50s. But the one thing you're not seeing here, you're not seeing him fake that ball to that back and take off running.
Nope, doesn't have to right now.
You won't see him running the ball by design.
Lamont Taylor ran it that time by design. Down to the 42-yard line. One of 2 teams to score 50 or more in 5 games. And you know who the other one is, and they might be on their way to not only meeting each other, but USC might be on their way to 50 again today, the way John's been doing the Matt Leinart updates for us from New York. Salvin Young now joins Vince Young in the backfield on a 3rd down, kind of a rare 3rd down. They haven't had many. 3rd and 4. Blitz coming. Here they do come. He stands in, wheels, fires in and out of the hands of his intended receiver, Billy Pittman.
Tad behind him, yeah.
Theo Baines got a hand on it to break it up.
Yeah, and it was behind him, but just a tad, and that allowed Baines to get it. But how about the presence of Vince in the pocket? He just
wheels around.
Wheels around, gathers himself.
Nice play by Baines right
there.
See,
that ball is further to the left, out in front of the receiver. It doesn't get knocked away, but nice play.
So the punter, Richmond McGee, who kicked a couple early in the first couple minutes, hasn't had much to do since. Set to kick on 4th down. Gonna aim it to the far side. And it bounces, and it's
a nice play.
Oh, great play, but it goes in.
Good effort by Ross.
Ross, who had a punt return for a touchdown, almost downed that punt at the 1 yard line, but the ball took a funny hop over the pylon and into the corner of the end zone. But look at the effort. You know, they have a lot of their starters that play on special teams. And that's just a beautiful attempt laid out for it, but then the ball took that hop and it's at the 20 yard line for Kansas. So Kansas has not gotten anything going off offensively, and again they find themselves 80 yards from the Texas end zone.
Let me ask you a question. I think Vince is happy. I mean, because you know he's not going to get to play much.
That's probably true.
He wants to play.
At the line of scrimmage, Clark Green is going to be swarmed under by a host of Longhorns, led by Ocam and Babineau. We asked you a Aflac trivia question earlier. What former Jayhawk or Longhorn is credited with inventing the football helmet? Who wants to take a shot at this? Swanee?
I'm going last because I know the answer.
Oh, you do know the answer?
I do know the answer.
I'm going to guess John Outland from Kansas, the Outland Trophy guy.
It's in the book.
Is it?
I actually saw it.
Oh, good. Tell me.
Naismith.
There you go.
The man credited with inventing basketball took a football, cut it in half, and strapped it over his head.
You guys are awesome.
You didn't look at your media guy this week.
I had other things on my mind. I've almost conceded this duck to you anyway. So, Dr. James Naismith. And that is a good-looking helmet.
He wore it sideways.
Yeah. That's nice.
He should have embedded the face mask.
Some kind of cover.
Yeah.
So Bob continues to lead. Swanee's drawn even with me, and time is running out on both of us. Not enough games left, I don't think, unless we really put out a storm at the end. Or Mr. Greasy's going to be.
Look out!
Intercepted. Aaron Ross might have a second touchdown. Stretches out. Didn't quite get there. Number 31 took it 31 yards.
Saw
down
that
to the 1 yard line.
Saw that coming all the way. Doesn't look like the receiver and the quarterback are on the same page. It looks like the quarterback was expecting a slant for the receiver to be inside, and the only guy that was inside was Ross.
They officially spot Aaron down at the 3 yard line, just inside the three. Big day for that guy, huh? Wow. Punt return for a touchdown, an interception where he almost scored.
And he's not even a starter.
That's right.
Well, Mac says he is. I mean, they say they've got 6-7 guys that are considered starters in that secondary.
They got the big freshman in there, tailback right now, Melton. They fake it to him, Young. Touchdown! Peter Ullman is back up tight end. Four touchdown passes for Vince Young. If you didn't have him in your Heisman finalists, I'm not sure why, but he might be going up that list a little bit. The ballots come out this week, by the way.
That'd be a good, that'd be an interesting one this year. And it will be made even more interesting because of the two other top candidates on the same team taking votes away from each other.
Exactly. Four touchdown passes to four different receivers for Vince Young. It's 49 to nothing. Somebody needs to go to the store for more ammunition. Vince Young buying time with his legs and lobbing it to his tight end for the touchdown. ...49-0 Texas, 4:12 remaining in the second quarter. Vince Young, a career high, four touchdown passes in this first half. He and his receivers taking a break on the sideline. 213 yards, 11 out of 18. Four different receivers for touchdown two. He's keeping everybody happy. Thompson from the four. And he's mowed under at about the 23 yard line on the kick return. Take a look at our Pacific Life game summary. And a lot of Vince Young, as you probably would gather. First, it was a 45-yard touchdown to Lima Swede to put him up 7-0.
And Jamal Charles scored on a 10-yard run. Then Vince hooked up with Quan Cosby, 64 yards. Cosby goes into the touchdown. Aaron Ross, a 71-yard punt return for a score, made it 28-0 to end the first quarter. And then Ramontz Taylor scored on an 8-yard run. And Young to Thomas, a 29-yard touchdown. And then just moments ago, Vince to Peter Ullman, his other tight end. 49-0. It's enough to make you jump around a little bit if you're a Longhorn fan. What a day. Kansas will work from its own 28-yard line. They have not officially run a play in Texas territory. They had it at one point, but they had a penalty called before they snapped it. So that backed them up in their own territory. They've been spending most of the day on their side of the, all day on their side of the 50. Right now they're 2-30.
And if you're a Kansas Jayhawk here, you want to come out of this the rest of the game with some kind of positive thoughts, because you're still hoping to get in a bowl game. You're 5-4. After this, you're going to be 5-5. Next week, you've got Iowa State at home, where you haven't been beaten all year. And if you win that ball game, you're in a bowl game. The second bowl game in the last 3 years for Mangino.
Second down and 8. Gordon trots over in a slot on the left side. They're going to throw it over there that way. And he's buried by 4 Longhorns, led by Bobadil.
Pass complete to number 3, Charles Gordon.
Mark Mangino, of course, was with Bob Stoops at Oklahoma, along with Chuck Long, his offensive coordinator. And you know that it's not going to be like the basketball team. It's going to be a struggle to build a winning football program. And in his fourth year, they were looking and hoping for not only an upset, but a game that would make them bowl eligible, as Bob said.
That's
a long ways off right now.
I'll tell you one thing he's got right now, and that is a championship defense.
Yep.
You can win anywhere with this defense that he's got. Not today, because you haven't had much help. You've turned the ball over inside the 5 twice, and they've hit some big plays, and your offense has made 1 first down in the first 8 or 9 possessions. So your offense has not stayed on the field, but this defense is a good defense. It doesn't look like it with Texas scoring 49 points.
Kyle Tucker, he's going to need ice on his foot by halftime here. Punting the ball for Kansas. Ross is back waiting. After his interception moments ago, led to another touchdown. He scored one already himself. This time they're going to chase it over to the far side, and he won't have an opportunity to return it. And it'll be spotted at about the 28-yard line. We reminded you earlier, big game coming up in Athens. Alabama is leading LSU 10-0 in SEC play at halftime. Alabama trying to remain unbeaten. Not scoring a lot of points, but that defense of Coach Shula's is pretty darn good.
Talk about a guy that's done a great job. Coach of the Year candidate, Mike Shula, huh?
No doubt. Vince Young still at the controls here with a couple minutes left in the half. Swede makes a catch and stripped out of there, but it's still going to be about a 9-yard gain. Alabama trying to remain undefeated and stay in the hunt for possibly a shot at the national championship. And ironically enough, they started in 66, they were 11-0, won the national title, and then they won the title every 13 years since then.
No, 79, they didn't.
Huh? 79 and 92, and then this would be the next one, 2005.
66, 79, 92, and now this year.
And this year. So, I don't know, that lucky 13 for them, you never know.
That's it.
Here's a give to Taylor. He's got a first down across the 40 to the 42. Still on his feet. Whoop, that's getting a little chippy down there. Frustration, obviously, on the side of Kansas. And the offensive line of Texas has really done some kind of job. There's big Jonathan Scott, Casey Studdard, and Justin Blaylock, Will Allen, Lyle Centline. Studdard's the guy, number 64 right there, the left guard. They say he's the only guy that ever talks in a huddle except Vince, and he never shuts up. Here's a throw, complete. Across midfield again, close to another first down.
Yeah, I asked Vince yesterday, I said, you know, now your quarterbacks control the huddle. When you walk in the huddle, is there anybody that is talking. I mean, I was thinking about the receivers and maybe some of the offensive linemen. But they all laughed. They all said stutter.
Stutter's a throwback, they say. He's like a football player from yesteryear. Here's Ramon Taylor again on a counter going the other way this time. And got another first down. Stutter, of course, if the name rings a bell, Casey's daddy was a heck of a player, too, and played in the National Football League for a long time. And they're very, they look very similar. His dad was taller and more slender, probably, than Casey. But facially, they look quite a bit alike. And those guys will get after it. You look at three guys on that offensive line, their dads all played football. Jonathan Scott's dad, Ray, played and was drafted into the NFL. We mentioned Dave Stutter, Casey's dad, and Lyle Sendline. Robin Sendline was a heck of a linebacker, played with the Vikings and the Dolphins.
That's right.
So they got some good genes up there on that offensive front for the Longhorns. And then they got a guy behind him that's pretty cool and calm, too.
First and 10 from the 36.
First down for Texas, just inside the Kansas 37. Vince Young might want more. Deep middle, got his man inside the 15. It's Billy Pittman. And a pickup of 24 more yards. So Texas might get another touchdown here before halftime.
Well, they're just, nobody's getting close to Young. As you see right there, he just got all kinds of time. And his receivers getting open downfield. We were told that they were probably going to hit the slot guy, Pittman, or the tight end. The two inside guys seem to be open against this defense.
Young keeps it. I didn't think we'd see him handle the ball running much today. Hasn't had to. And now he gets swarmed under by Banks, Floodman, and company. Yeah, a little pushing and shoving, getting up. Trying to get their quarterback, and there's Stutter, the guy we were just talking about. He's in the mix. Coming up on the Capital One halftime show, John and Craig and Aaron will have highlights and analysis from all of this afternoon's big games. Plus, they'll preview that one we talked about on ESPN's primetime game tonight, Auburn and Georgia, in an SEC battle with huge BCS implications. If Georgia can keep winning, they would go to the title game in Atlanta and then maybe have a shot to play in the Sugar Bowl there. Those guys are coming along with all the scores in about a minute, 23 seconds.
Who called timeout?
Texas did.
Texas did.
It's getting to the point of boredom for the Longhorn fans, 49-0.
I'm just thinking if there's some revenge type of thing to get to what Mark Mangino said last year after that ball game. If these guys, I mean, they don't need to call timeout.
And one of the guys, when it was reminded to the Texas team about Coach Mangino's comments that we showed you earlier, one of the guys that took exception was Vince Young. And he went around and said, you know, you can diss the players, but don't diss the Texas coaches. They're our guys. And so he made it pretty apparent all week long that that memory was stuck in his mind. And he's still in there with a 49-point lead with a minute and 23 remaining in the half.
Well, I doubt if you'll see him in the second half.
I wouldn't think so.
That wasn't a misprint. One first down for Kansas versus 16, I believe it was, for the Longhorns.
Three for three in the red zone already. Young to throw. Dropped the ball. And got back. And got back on top of it, this time with a little more urgency. So that backs him all the way up to the 27-yard line. Loss of about 12. Brandon Perkins was the guy that caused the fumble. He's one of the top sack guys. There he comes, undersized, coming around the corner.
Yeah, he's got 9 sacks already this season. They don't list him on their 2-deep. He's a smaller guy, but he was rushing against a tight end.
And now Jayhawk player down. I think it's Jerome Kemp who's shaking up on the play. Working on his lower left leg. They're going to reset the clock to 1:15 as we look at Jerome Kemp and working on his lower left leg. So Jerome, the junior out of Wichita, being helped off the field. And Sadiq Muhammad will take his spot back there at that safety spot. They've been busy safeties today, that's for sure. Meanwhile, Texas has a third down and 24 upcoming. And Vince Young already with a career-high 4 touchdown passes.
You would assume it's going to be in the air here. And they may not be able to get a first down, but they can get it down closer for their field goal kicker because they would have to get inside the three right now for a first down.
But you got so many game breakers, playmakers. Get them the ball on a slant and let these guys run. They can make a few moves and jerks, and they're in the end zone.
They're going to bring the blitz. There's the quick toss to the tight end. He's run out of bounds. David Thomas goes out at about the 18-yard line, and that will make it a little closer for the kicker. That'll bring out David Pino, one of the seniors on the season. He's 9 of 11. He hasn't had to kick many field goals when you got an offense this good. He's warming it up right
Look
now.
Look how little the kicker is compared to the... Look how little.
David, one of the guys introduced to senior, as Mack Brown gave them all a big hug coming out of the tunnel. This will be a 35-yard field goal attempt to try to put 50-plus on the board again in a half for Texas. Dino from 35, the kick on the way, and it's up, and it's good. So, for the first time today, Texas doesn't get in the end zone. But they do get a 35-yard field goal from their senior place kicker. Just under a minute remaining in the first half. Back at Darrell K. Royal, Texas Memorial Stadium. Brad Nessler, Bob Greasy, Lynn Swan, our ABC crew in front of a happy group of Longhorns as they lead it 52-0 in the first half over Kansas.
What'd you say? 52?
52-0. Just kind of hoping wouldn't have to get that word out today, at least to nothing. Greg Johnson to kick. Thompson and Green wait on the other end. It doesn't help on a kick return when you get that cannon shot right in your ear when you're trying to field it at the 3-yard line, I wouldn't imagine.
Yeah, you got your back down there.
Yeah.
You jump 4 feet in the air before the ball got there.
Thompson got out to about the 21-yard line. Dr. Pepper, Big 12 updates. Oklahoma survived Texas A&M. They had a strong start and then a game that took about 4 hours and 10 minutes if you joined us after that one.
Yeah, Oklahoma's, I think they've won like four in a row now.
Yeah, Texas Tech falls to Oklahoma State. Nebraska is leading Kansas State. Missouri on top of Baylor, and Colorado and Iowa State tonight is the big one for the Big 12 North. And could be the elimination, or if Colorado wins that, they're going to be going to Houston to play a Texas team that already thumped them once.
Yeah, but that was here.
That was here.
And
they're running out of Winchester shells, I'm telling you. Shotgun like that, and you do some serious duck hunting. Four shells at once.
I wouldn't get around the front of that thing.
I wouldn't either. That's Marty down there, probably our camera guy, isn't it?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, good job, Marty. Duck, dude. So we're down final 25 seconds of the half. Bring three wide receivers out to the near side, and Swanson will be under center. They're going to keep it on the ground, get to the locker room, and I don't know if there's such a thing as regrouping in a situation like this, but the first half mercifully will come to a close. And the Texas Longhorn fans giving their team a standing ovation as they head out to the tunnel. 31 seniors making their final appearance, and boy, have they appeared here at home today. End of the half. Texas 52-0. John, Craig, and Aaron will be along with the Capital One Halftime Show right after this message and a word from our ABC station. You're watching ABC Sports Championship Television.
How good is this Texas team, okay? Offensively, they're going against a very good Kansas defense.
Right.
So I'm very impressed with this offense. Now, defensively, for Texas, this Kansas offense is not much, and I don't think they've really been tested. But I've been impressed with the special teams of Texas.
Exactly.
Because they've covered well, and they've run well, and they've got some turnovers.
And
free kick out of bounds. Ball will be placed on the 35-yard line. First down.
They'll spot it on the 35, and we'll spot Swanee.
Well, thank you, Brad. I talked to Mark Mangino when he came out in the field, and His response is what I suspected. It's about personal pride, he said. This is a good football team. He faces it. His team understands it. But the players don't want to play next to a guy who gives up in the ball game. So what he wants his team to do is come out and play hard in the second half, keep their heads in the ball game and stay focused and get better and not give up, because they have to carry the results of this game with them for the rest of the season.
Yep, no doubt. And they start off well. They got it at the 35 through a 6-yard pass complete. And they'll start at about the 41-yard line. Swanee, did you talk to Mack about whether or not Vince Young's going to play in the second half?
I did. He said that they've always had a game plan where Vince stays into the ball game through the third quarter and the ones on defense play. But the question is, he doesn't want to get him hurt. He's going to come out, think about it, probably let Vince start the first series of the ball game to see how that goes. Then he's going after that, Brad.
Here's the start for Kansas that they were looking for. They got a touchdown.
Yeah, that might change Mack's thinking a little bit.
John Cornish just took it about 60 yards for a score. And Kansas on the board.
Well, this is what Kansas needed at the beginning of the ball game. This is what they did last week against Nebraska with a long touchdown run. That hardly impacts the outcome of this ball game, however.
So Cornish with the long touchdown run, and he outran a very speedy secondary, so he showed his wheels. Longest play from scrimmage allowed by Texas all year long, right there. And the extra points is up and good. But John Cornish, we told you that he'd play. He and Clark Green had shared time. Here he is on that option. And he got the corner and he was gone.
And yeah, and the question is, that is the first team defense out there for Texas. And what a heck of a motivator and a heck of a speech by Mark Mangino to get him to come out here and play as well as they did in the first drive.
Did something right, that's for sure. Good job, Mr. Cornish. Touchdown run makes it 52-7 in the opening minute here of the first quarter. First points allowed since that second quarter I mentioned of Oklahoma State. It had been 142 or 145 unanswered, somewhere in there. And that'll fire up, I would imagine, the Texas defense. A little bit of a wake-up call.
Bob, Brett, that will fire him up. I want to add one more thing that Mack Brown said when he left the field at halftime. He said, you know, they're going to get their number twos and threes into this ball game. They're going to play. But, you know, he's up against between the rock and the hard place. He doesn't want his guys to quit. He wants his guys to continue to play hard. But he doesn't want to be in the position where he's running up the score, which you can't stop your number twos and threes from going out there and playing hard football and putting up more points.
That's exactly right. They don't get the opportunity all that often. Our Pacific Life game summary. First half, statistically, as you might expect, pretty lopsided in the favor of the Longhorns. 383 total yards, so maybe on their way to another 600-yard total offense type day. Those penalties were costly for Kansas early, and they had the turnover that cost them on the kick return.
Only one first down for Kansas.
8 3-and-outs.
No, not pretty.
Here's a give to Taylor. And Ramatz gets it out to the 22, almost the 23-yard line. Muhammad made the stop from the secondary. College Station, Thanksgiving weekend, Reliance Stadium in Houston. And then there's that Rose Bowl out there. Well, they got everything ready. They had the process of elimination. I assume they're going to take those signs and check them off every place they go.
Well, you know, it's great for the fans. The anticipation, which is part of the best part of anything, is the anticipation of going on a trip, going on a cruise, going to the Rose Bowl, going to the championship game. But that's good for the fans, but not for the players and coaches.
Full start, 16 offense, 5-yard penalty, second down.
David Thomas saying, my fault, guys. Penalty on the tight ends. Offensive leaders for Texas in the first. David was among them with 3 catches for 70 yards, including a touchdown. Ramatz, a touchdown run with 56 yards, and Vince Young, a career high in one half, 4 touchdowns. Taylor on the ground again. Kansas bottling him up, trying to bring him down anyway. They never do quite get him down. So Clemson, I guess, a winner today over Florida State again. Let's check in with John on that one. Charlie Whitehurst's been a tough cookie his 4 years at Clemson there, and good for him. He had a bad shoulder. They didn't know how effective he'd be, and he had a great game. Tip pass is caught by Billy Pittman on the ricochet. And Billy's got a first down.
Hey, how tough is that? I mean, how tough is playing your own son? I mean, and his brother is on your side as we take a look at from behind the Kansas defense. He's looking to our right, and then he comes back, almost gets sacked, and then wants to throw it, and then the ball is tipped, and he still catches.
He got away from Perkins, who forced him to fumble in the first half once. Stretch play here. Taylor following his blockers, but brought down from behind by Nick Reed. Nice tackle by the captain, outside linebacker out of Derby, Kansas. 6'4", 230-pounder, the number two tackler in the conference. This is his 40th straight start for Nick. And Nick was talking this week, said, boy, I know the play that I remember the most from last year when we played Texas. It was fourth down and 18. Vince Young took off on a run. Nick said, I thought I had a beat on him. He put a move on me, and I didn't get the tackle. He picked up 22 yards and a first down, and subsequently they went on and won. And he said, it's the only time Vince Young said anything to him during the game. He says, you got to keep your head up. I just did a Texas two-step on you. It's Taylor. Ramatz goes out to the 48-yard line, pick up a 13-4.
And Nick remembered that, huh?
Yeah, Nick remembers that. But that was the play that really saved the game for Texas last year, because they were in danger of losing, and here was the pump fake. You're going to see number seven come into the screen. Whoop, not enough. And the extra few yards gave him the first down and kept the drive alive.
The old Texas
two-step. Yeah. Yep.
Only thing you ever said to me. You got to keep your head up.
First down, and Charles breaks open and almost got out of there. Charles bounced off Nick Reed again, eventually did go down, and Nick's got to re-snap the chin gear there. Charles, a true freshman out of Port Arthur, Texas, and Bob said he was highly touted. In fact, Port Arthur broke the Port Arthur City career rushing record. You know who that belonged to?
No.
Little Joe Washington.
Oh, yes. Little Joe,
Oklahoma, and then on to the NFL.
But you know, this is probably the top state for in regards to numbers of quality Division I players.
Young, the quick throw, complete. You know, to Jones.
You know, Florida gets a lot of them, produces a lot of players. California produces a lot of the players. Ohio, Pennsylvania, and that area. But as far as pure numbers of top quality, I don't think anybody does it more so than Texas.
Well, the state's as big as most countries, so you got a lot of high schools. And they play a lot of football, and it's Friday night lights down here, boy. It's big on Friday nights, and it's big on Saturday afternoons in the state.
I remember Mack Brown, when he left 8 years ago, when he left North Carolina, he talked about that exact thing, about recruiting in North Carolina in that area and then recruiting in the state of Texas.
Thomas is going to have a first down, I think. Randy Fowler made the tackle, pick up a six.
I remember Mac saying that at North Carolina, he was the second sport. The second,
right?
Because of basketball.
The basketball.
But going to Texas, not only was he the number one sport at the school, but everybody wanted to come. All the recruits liked Texas and wanted to come, whereas in North Carolina, you're competing against all these other schools, Duke and NC State and all the other schools in the ACC. And you couldn't win the conference down there.
Right. Young, play action, zips it. Pittman almost got it. Billy got a hand on it, couldn't quite get the second hand on it. Well, there's something like 1,600 high schools in Texas, something in that area.
Uh-huh.
And, boy.
There was only like 350 like in North Carolina.
Yeah.
And he said, just right there.
And guys, when you throw into the mix coaches like Hayden Fry, who when he was at SMU, and then he went up to Iowa, the contacts he had down here with the high school coaches, he made sure he had a staff at Iowa that could recruit well in Texas, and that helped build the Iowa program.
No doubt. A blitz coming from Kansas. Taylor might run right by it. Gets caught up in the traffic at about the 36-yard line. Charles Keith made the stop.
You know, one of the things I'll always remember about Mack, and I've known him for a long time, when he left North Carolina, He said, you know, in the ACC in North Carolina, it's tough to win
the conference
title because of FSU at North Carolina. He says, at Texas, you have a chance to win a national title. Didn't mention conference. He says, at Texas, because of the recruiting and the players in the state. If you can get out of the conference, you've got a chance to win a national title.
Of course, they're just a couple games away from having that chance if they keep playing like this. Here's Salvin Young, swivels his hips, and he's got a first down inside the 30. They've got nice depth at that tailback position. Ramontz Taylor started. We've seen Jamal Charles really have big plays about every time he's touched it. And Salvin Young, who's kind of the veteran of the three anyway, a junior out of Houston.
All three of those guys have some shake and bake in them, and they can all take it the whole way.
And there's the cake after you shake and bake. That's 271 pounds of tailback Henry Melton.
He's a true freshman also, waiting to get some time.
Charles, nice spin move outside.
What kind of cake was that?
The truck said pound cake. That's a good one. Oh, boy. Yeah, we'll have a second down coming up. He's been in only a few snaps today. Selvin, as we said, almost always in there on third down. Melton's got 7 touchdowns rushing as he's kind of a battering ram down close. He came in when they had first and goal at the 3-yard line. They faked it to him, and that's where Vince Young found his backup tight end for the touchdown.
And so the reason they like Selvin on third downs is because he knows the offense better, and versus blitzes, he knows who to block and who to pick up, and he knows the checkoffs.
13th play of this drive. Charles takes it wide, got the corner, got the first. Knocked out of bounds by Mike Rivera, the inside linebacker, but not before he got it down near the 15-yard line.
And Charles is still learning, obviously, how to run and how to make things work. You know, he'll get over to the sidelines as you watch on the replay here, and his coaches will talk to him, and they'll tell him, look, at this point in the ball game, yes, you want to run the ball, get as much as you can, but keep it in bounds. Keep the clock moving, because we got a pretty good lead here.
Yep.
But I love the way the coaches describe him. They said he is a human highlight film.
Well, he is. 300-meter hurdle champion for the whole nation last year. So not only can he run fast, he can run fast a long ways. Vince snaps it out there, complete to Ahmad Hall, a senior. And celebrating Veterans Day, no doubt, as he is a veteran. He's over in Afghanistan. There's our guys, the pilots from before the ball game. Gump Harrelson and Tad Niemer and Frank Wilson and Conger Giroux, the guys that had the Marine Fighter 122 attack squadron from Buford, South Carolina. I was thinking about maybe those guys give me a ride home tonight.
Yeah, we
Let's
may
go
need
that
them.
Way.
Yeah, we may need them.
Yeah.
That was the 10th different receiver. Texas has hit the ceiling.
Making everybody happy. On the ground, Ramontz Taylor to the secondary, into the end zone. Touchdown, Texas. Yards. Ramontz Taylor, second touchdown of the day. Got a nice block from Casey Studdard en route to the end zone. And it's 58-7. Good. 15 plays and 80 yards in over 8 minutes. They passed only when they had to for the most part there. Pino's point after up and good. 59-7, the third 80-yard or more touchdown drive of the day. And number 11 caps it as he gets in the end zone one more time. And they're getting closer. It'll be 10-0 here in about an hour. Richmond McGee is going to kick off. I think Greg Johnson's leg sore from kicking off. To the 1-yard line is Kenneth Thompson. And Thompson will be run out before he can get to the 25-yard line. Let's check in with Swanee.
Hey guys, you know, I can't ask for a better grandson. A better grandson than you. You are the center of my life. Be good, take care, and remember, never say no to him, and he's taken this to heart every day of his life.
Yeah, that was pretty interesting when he was. He spent so much time giggling and goofing around until Swanee asked him that question about what's been the biggest thing. And boy, you could hear a pin drop in the whole room when he was telling that story.
Yeah, it was interesting, all the responses by all those guys.
So upcoming a third down. I'm sure Grandma's got a pretty good seat today. Probably better than we all have.
Yeah, and it says a lot also about the kind of program that Matt Brown runs and Sally's involvement with the team. The guys really talk about it being a family and sticking together.
Yep. Third down and 11 for Kansas. Blitz might come from the corner. Here they come. Swanson's in trouble, and he's going to dump it, and it'll probably be intentional grounding, or was he outside the box? I don't think so. Unless there was a guy in the general vicinity.
Yeah, Cornish, I think.
Cornish,
was
I guess,
there.
Was close. Roderick Wright. Big Rod making the push in there. Senior out of Houston. All-American candidate on most of the lists, Lombardi's and Outlands and all those award possibilities. Kansas 0 for 10 on their third down. So another punt coming from Kyle Tucker. And again, I've said it many times, right from about his own goal line. That's the spot he's been kicking from a lot today. Quan Crosby is back, and he'll take it at the 30. And he got about 12 on the return. So good field position for Texas with a big lead. And 5 minutes and change remaining in the third quarter. It is 59-7. Matt Nordgren coming in to take over. Matt, senior out of Dallas, doesn't get a lot of playing time because of number 10. Hands it off, and Charles will go down. Actually, a loss of about a yard. Joe Mortensen made the tackle.
Senior playing on senior day, right?
Yep, and like we said, he was one of the captains. And, you know, 31 seniors, and Mac Brown told us it's really hard to have captains. We weren't quite sure how to do it because you're going to make somebody's mom or dad upset that maybe their kid wasn't a captain. What they did do because of Veterans Day, they had a gentleman around here who was a lawyer in town. He was a war veteran, highly decorated war veteran, who's been at every practice, I think, since Coach Royal was here. And so he was one of the captains. Ahmad Hall, who is a veteran, a Marine who had been in Afghanistan, was another one of the captains. And then Matt Nordgren was a captain because he's been a team player and not gotten a lot of playing time and has hung in there and worked hard every day just like everybody else. And he not only was named a captain for today, but he carried out the American flag out of the tunnel at the beginning of the ballgame. So there's Ahmad, number 46. Big fullback and a good player, 235-pounder.
Nordgren, Matt, also holds for field goals and the extra points, so he does get involved with the team in that regard.
Here he is to throw. And it tipped at the line, and it's intercepted. And it's Kevin Kane, the linebacker. They finally drag him down. Charlton Keith is the guy that got a hand on it. First turnover of the day for the Longhorns. Ball was tipped and then picked off by the middle linebacker.
Well, the offense does change when Vince goes out and another quarterback comes in. They have a package that Nordgren runs. He doesn't run nearly the option style plays. Here's the linebacker. Watch as he's going to drop back, and the ball is going to get tipped.
Keith's the guy that got a hand on it. Kane, the interceptor. First down at the 28-yard line. And breaking tackles. Clark Green down the sideline. Michael Griffin ran him out of bounds. Pickup of 12 for Green as Cornish has the one Kansas touchdown today. That's the first play that Kansas had initiated. Started a play in Texas territory. The other touchdown run was past midfield. So there's Clark Green's numbers. Good solid back. Both these guys are. They come in with very similar numbers, Green and Cornish.
Clark Green's got a career 120 pass receptions. He's very good catching the ball out of the backfield, obviously.
They give inside, breaking tackles and head to the end zone. Brandon McAnderson. 15-yard touchdown run. So they immediately turn the interception into another Jayhawk score.
And this is what this is doing is what Mangino talked to Swanee about, coming out, doing some good things. Don't lose your pride. Come back out the second half. You're not going to win this ball game, but it may help them win next week's ball game and get into a bowl game.
Exactly. Scott Webb in for the point after. And the kick's up and good. So Kansas with a couple of scores in the second half, including this rumble by the fullback, capping a 28-yard drive following the interception. Darrell K. Royal Memorial Stadium here in Austin, Texas. Brad Nessler, Bob Greasy, and Lynn Swan, along with our ABC crew and about 80,000 of our close burnt orange-clad fans watching their team put it on Kansas 59-14, but Kansas has two touchdowns here in the third quarter. Lamont Taylor from about the one spins off and goes across the 20 to the 22. We talked about the possibility of this team getting a shot at a national championship in the Rose Bowl. Well, they beat fourth-ranked Arkansas in their last game of the regular season when they went to a national championship, finished 10-0 to win the UPI national title. And Coach Royal, part of that, 63, 69, and 70. And lost to Notre Dame in the Cotton Bowl, so they won half of it. Nebraska won the other half. Coach Royal, the statue over there in the corner.
And one of the first things that Mack Brown did when he first arrived in Austin is he went and met with Darrell Royal and says, hey, I want you a part of anything that if I come here, I want your approval. I want you behind me and behind this program, and I want you involved in this program.
And he's still around a lot. And President Nixon giving him the trophy championship plaque.
Their last championships, they won the championship, what, 63, 69, and 70.
Yep. Here's the give to the big fella. And Henry Melton's got a first down.
I still think that win back at the Rose Bowl last year really set this team. I mean, they're, you know, they had gotten beat. They had never been in the BCS Bowl. They had lost to Oklahoma last year. They got in the BCS Bowl. They got to the Rose Bowl. Here's Michigan. They come from behind. They beat Michigan in an outstanding, a great game. Vince Young lights it up. And then the following year, the second game this year, they go to Ohio State. At Ohio State, they beat them on a Saturday night on national television. Kind of validates
yep.
that whole Michigan win by beating another Big Ten team. The two best Big Ten teams over the years, they beat in a matter of three or four games.
And then the giant monkey they got off their back in the Cotton Bowl in Dallas in the Red River rivalry, finally beating Oklahoma, which so many years of 10 wins, 11 wins, but it was that Oklahoma thing that was stuck right there that never gave them a shot. And after taking care of Oklahoma this year, now they're rolling along, and they are as confident a group as I think we've ever been around.
Yeah, exactly. They're 16 wins in a row. This will be their 17th. And only short of what USC is doing. And I kind of see in this group that what I saw in USC.
Yep.
They're very confident. They're positive they're going to win. You didn't see that in Texas last year during the season. But after that Rose Bowl game and early in the season when they beat Ohio State and then Oklahoma, they think they can beat anybody and do anything.
If they had a $10 bill with Vince Young's picture on it, it would be in Vince we trust. You can just tell the whole team just goes, hey, we got him. When we have VY, we always have a chance. That's what they say. Here's a first down run by Selvin Young. But they've talked since the beginning of camp that this is where, and already they have beaten Colorado this year rather handily. They put 40 on them as well. Colorado getting a little bit better every week too, though. But they got a big ball game tonight. They got their hands full tonight.
They're at Iowa State.
Yep. 40 seconds remaining in the third quarter. Melton gets a handoff, got a big hole, makes a big hole of his own. He is all the way down to the 26-yard line. That's 270 pounds moving pretty quickly. He's a dancing bear, as you would say.
You know, you're right, and he's another running back, another freshman running back. But we were talking to Mac about that. Look at this guy. Look how big he is. 270 pounds. But we were talking about, I said, Mac, how do you get all these freshmen? How do you get all these freshmen next year's class? How do you get these guys to come? He says, we just tell them we're going to play them.
That's right.
If you're good enough, you're going to play. And they have two or three freshman running backs that play, and they have two or three freshman wide receivers that are playing on their right, and they play, and they're good.
Big Henry went 22 yards for a first down. And now he just bulldozes his way. Man, you hear the pods, the pads popping down there. As he got down to the 21, picked up four or five more. As the quarter's going to come to a close with a bang. 59-14. Our presentation of college football continues after this message and a word from our ABC stations. You're watching ABC Sports Championship Television. And speaking of veterans and Veterans Day, good to have you along with us, fellas. Texas will work at the 21-yard line to open up the fourth and final quarter. Eighth play of this drive with Matt Nordgren in now for Vince Young at quarterback. He's in the shotgun. And he'll hand it off to Salvin Young. Left side, Salvin got a block. Got the first, might have it all. Touchdown!
He just outran the defenders that had an angle on him.
21 yards for Salvin Young for the touchdown. Everybody getting in the act. Well, over 60 last week against Baylor. And now, with the extra point pending, 65 here. 78-yard drive.
Hey, little brother. Hey, boy, don't be going up to here. You can't go ahead.
On the first play of the fourth quarter, another touchdown. And Kyle Phillips in to kick. You know it's a good day when your backup place kicker is knocking in extra points. Salvin Young saw that opening, burst through it, found the end zone. It's 66-14, Longhorns. Texas outscores its opponents in every quarter. They do so again today. The 66 points, if you start wondering, say, you know, how long has it been since they've scored 66 points? 1977. They've hung a 68 zip on Virginia. Here's the kick. Kenneth Thompson will take it. He's been a busy kick returner today. And he very seldom gets out much more than the 20-yard line. Now the BCS away. Well, they might get another look at Colorado in a few weeks. And then maybe even bigger and brighter futures will lie in Pasadena. Watson's pass out to Gordon. Gordon weaving through traffic, and he looks like he's got a first down. He does. To go back to the Big 12 championships, Texas over Nebraska down there on the bottom in 96. But since that time and since the inception of the BCS, they have not won the Big 12 championship, and they want to get there. That could be the rematch right there. Rematch of 4 years ago.
Colorado's been in that championship game two of the last 3 years, and if they win this year, they'll be at 3 of 4, so.
They know how to take care of the North pretty well.
Yeah, they do.
Here's a good looking run by Clark Green again. Down the sideline, almost got away. Let's find out what's going on in the ACC. Let's check in again. Two plays back from the Florida State game.
Look out, Miami, if their quarterback starts playing.
Yep. John Cornish. The carry.
You know that that first game of the year between Miami and Florida State.
Yes, that's the 1 second away from being undefeated for Penn State.
And that's for sure. The difference in Florida State and Miami is that Miami and their quarterback has improved the second half of the season, whereas Florida State doesn't seem to have done that.
Swanson had it knocked down at the line of scrimmage. Batted down by that Texas front. talk about so much about whether or not
Miami is the ACC champion, I project, so they play those two.
Swanson throwing long. His man got a little bit turned around. He might have had a play on it. It was Gordon, the intended receiver. Go back one more time, kind of finish our PCF.
And Bob, you're picking Georgia. You think Georgia or win out over Alabama?
I'm picking Georgia, yeah. Ness forced me to do that.
I did not get involved. They got a big game tonight on ESPN, though, against Auburn. And then they have Kentucky. Then they have their annual get-together on Thanksgiving Saturday against Georgia Tech. And then it would be the SEC championship. Well, they're number two, we know that. You put those hook'em horns up, they could be number one when it's all over. Stretching over the stadium and the course, and 66-14 lead for the Texas Longhorns on their home field. Look at those digital cameras. You get a perfect shot all the time. The only problem is when you take pictures that are bad, they're some of the funniest ones you'll ever get to keep, and most people just erase them.
Yes, that's true.
Nordgren in at quarterback. It gives to Melton. And he gets out to about the 13-yard line, pickup of one or two. Let's talk about who's hot and who's not.
Fresno won Thursday night. And Peyton and Eli.
Yeah.
Wouldn't that be something?
Would that be a matchup in the Super Bowl, huh?
They kept winning.
Second down at eight.
Yes, I told Peyton.
Nope.
I don't want Peyton to keep winning.
No, that would be a bad sign for your undefeated Dolphins.
Very bad
72.
Sign.
Who's not hot then?
And for those, for those who don't realize, Drew Rosenhaus is an agent, and Terrell Owens is his
one of his many headlines.
We had Terrell Owens up last week, so.
Melton breaking tackles and rumbling all the way down. To the 46-yard line, a 27-yard run. I tell you what, that big fella's got some pretty good wheels.
Yeah, he didn't want to go down, but finally, Floodman went over and just said, hey, big boy, you're going down.
Career-long run, though. Now, he does not look 270.
He looks big, and he's not as little, as shifty as those other guys. But he doesn't look 270, you're right.
Reminds me of Roosevelt Leakes.
I was
a little bit of Earl Campbell.
Sonny.
But yeah. Roosevelt Leakes, big man here at Texas, looks just like him.
We're starting to think alike. That's getting scary. I was thinking Rosie Leakes while you were saying that before you said it. Now they go back. One of the little guys, Hobbs, so 5'7 of them. So you go from 6'3, 270 to a 5'7 guy you can't find. We talked about Eli. You hit double figures.
You know, John Madden mentioned that on Monday Night Football, and I don't know. He must have watched our show, because I don't know how else he would have got that information.
Unless
other than we had a mole
around here.
Yeah.
It could be.
Oh, Bob, I want to point out one thing in that remaining schedule for Indianapolis. They play Pittsburgh.
Yes, they do.
And so Pittsburgh knocked off both Philadelphia last year.
Yes.
And then New England back-to-back to help you out.
Yes, you did. That's exactly right.
But I never did get my honorary bottle of a glass of champagne for helping you out last year.
Well, I'm going to tell you, take care of them this year.
Take it, and you'll send me the bottle. Right?
And I'll send you two.
Third down at 10 for Texas. And again, off the right side is Hobbs. And he's into Kansas territory. You never know if there's a mole in the group, but if there is one, it's way over there someplace.
It's over this way.
And it's looking around looking innocent. By the way, you're getting a shot of our booth. We are the last group to do a football game in what really isn't a booth. It's an outside cement deck. You freeze your butt off out here when it's cold. When it's windy, your papers fly all over. We've already signed the wall behind us. They're going to demolish this and make us a real press box, and we thank Bill Little and John Bianco and all the guys in the past years, all the coaches that we've complained about over the years, they're going to get us some really nice digs starting next year. So we're doing the last broadcast in this little bird's nest up here.
Yes.
9 minutes remaining in the ball game.
I saw Bill Little at halftime. I was walking down the hallway, and he were talking about a bunch of things. And he said, in his 38 years of working here, and other, he says he's been around here like 45 years, back with the championship teams and all that.
Right.
He says this is the best Texas football team that he has ever been around.
Well, they're awfully good, and they showed us in every capacity today. Just a couple little lapses, I think, more than anything else defensively today. But even they have awakened. And give Kansas credit for coming out and fighting hard in the second half. But, you know, if Texas still had Vince Young in there, it might be 100 to something. There we go. Last broadcast, 11-12-05. Got my signature.
I got to get over there.
You got to get over there. We got Clint's. We got to get Pat McGrath. We'll get everybody situated, and then we won't be in this spot anymore.
Forge my name up there while you're
Swanee, I know what your signature looks like. I can get it up there for you. Second down, 11 for Swanson. Gives it off to Green, trying to weave his way through traffic. And he got out to the 21-yard line. Today in the Big 12, a couple of surprises. Oklahoma State over 12th-ranked Texas Tech, a little bit of a shocker. Oklahoma and A&M had a pretty good ball game. Missouri a winner over Baylor. And Kansas had to come from behind to beat Kansas State, or rather Nebraska had to come from behind to beat Kansas State after Nebraska got thumped by Kansas last week. And then Colorado and Iowa State, that is the matchup tonight.
Well, the Big 12 has what, 8 bowl tie-ins?
Nice throw. And Marcus Henry on the receiving end of an 18-yard matchup. Speaking of that game tonight, with against Iowa State, if they get it. But Iowa State's been playing pretty darn well for Coach McCartney, and they'll be tough. Blitz coming off the corner. And they're going to wrap up the ball carrier for a loss of 2 on the play. Eric Hall brings down Cornish. As we approach the 7-minute mark remaining in the ball game.
Loss of 2 on the play.
Texas getting a lot of guys seeing extra time because of the disparity in the score, 66-14. And that'll only bode better for them down the road should anybody get banged up. There's big Casey Studdard.
Second and 12 from the 38.
He's still talking.
Texas,
Quick throw complete out to Herford. And Marcus Herford gets across a 45, pick up a 7.
Pass is complete, number 13, Marcus Herford.
Herford just ran over and ran out of bounds instead of trying to cut back inside and get some yards. Running backs today, for the most part, I mean, more often than not, seem to want to run out of bounds rather than stick their nose in ups and get some yardage upfield.
Third down at 5. Kansas just inside its own 45. That one got short-armed a little bit by Dominic Rue. Talked about champion.
Ain't nothing better than seeing Ralphie bring out the old Buffalo.
She ran well last week.
Yeah.
Both in the pregame and at halftime.
Yes, USC's got a good one. What's the name of the horse?
Traveler.
Trojan. Traveler.
6:25. Devo still doesn't look that interested, but his team does look pretty good. Summary, big game for Vince Young today. He got him going with an early touchdown pass and threw 3 more after that, 4 for a career high as he mixed it around to 10 different receivers today. Ramontz Taylor scored twice. Salvin Young got in the act the last time he touched it. A nice end around for 21 yards and a score. That puts us where we are at this point, 66-14. Big day for the offensive linemen. They did their job beautifully. And now we're down the final 6.5 minutes. Matt McCoy and a quarterback into the clear.
Number 13.
Out to the 46-yard line. 26-yard run by a guy that doesn't get a lot of time either.
Yeah, that fooled him. Nordgren doesn't do this very often.
No, this is McCoy. Matt McCoy.
Oh, it's McCoy.
And he takes off and shows great wheels. Got dragged down.
No, that's not McCoy. Yeah, it is, isn't it?
Yep.
All right.
And he comes back out after getting the play from the bench. Big first down run. give inside. That one's going nowhere. Swanee.
Well, guys, I got a little challenge for you here. We've been around this Texas football team a little bit, and I want you to see if you can match up these nicknames to the players they belong to. You know, Chips, Bambino, GTG, Big Bang. Think about that for a moment.
Okay.
Yeah.
You're talking about challenge. You think doing a 66 to 14 game is not a big enough challenge for me? Huh?
For all of us. This is how these little things get on the air.
Uh-huh. Okay. Texas second down. He gives the little guy Hobbs, and he's got another first down. Pickup of 12 more.
And so here are the answers for you.
I don't have a lot of guesses.
No guesses, but
Roderick Wright is Chips, huh?
He's Chips. Now, Chips and Big Bang kind of mean the same thing. Guys are telling me that Chips means, you know, he's got lots of chips, like poker chips. When he needs something from the equipment guy, you know, he's the guy who always is able to get it. Now, Bambino is because Rashard's coach couldn't say his last name, so he just called him Bambino. I'll tell you about GPG in a moment.
Most coaches can't say half the players' names anyway. GTG is Ahmad Hall.
GTG is Ahmad Hall. This is the one that really stuck me because GTG means the go-to guy. And when you're a sergeant in the Marines and you've served in Afghanistan and you come back home and you got a name like the go-to guy, go to my team anytime.
You got that right. Chips, Bambino, GTG, and Big Bang. And there's Big Bang, Justin Blaylock.
And there's always VY.
And we know what kind of game VY had today.
Big number 10.
Hobbs again. And no gain on the play. Rodney Allen made the tackle. Don't forget, time permitting, stay tuned for the Thrifty Car Rental postgame report. John, Craig, and Aaron will have all the scores and highlights from across the country. Tell you about any surprises along the way. Vince Young, four touchdown passes and didn't have to work much of the second half. So Texas A&M, the next game in their path to a perfect regular season before the Big 12 championship game. Marcus Myers getting into the act. Don't forget tonight on ESPN, big game between the Hedges in Athens, Georgia. And Auburn always plays Georgia tough in Athens. DJ Shockley coming back for the Bulldogs from that sprained knee, and he's ready to go. College football primetime presented by Polaroid on ESPN tonight at 7:45 Eastern Time. Also available in high definition on ESPN HD. A moon over Austin, Texas.
You know, the scary thing about this Texas team is
they don't lose a lot of guys.
They don't lose a lot. They got a lot of guys coming back. In fact, Bill Little said that, you know, this is the best team that he's seen in Texas in all the years he's been here. There's a lot of these guys coming back. I think 16 of the 22 starters.
Offense, 5 yards, fourth down.
They took the delay game on purpose. The whole punting team is over on the sideline.
16 of the 22 starters on this Texas team is back, including Vince Young. 8 on offense and 8 on the defensive side.
There's a guy that won't be. Jonathan Scott, big left tackle.
Kind of reminds me of USC when we did their game last year, the championship game. They had a lot of guys coming back.
Those lot of guys are still undefeated at number one. Yeah, Texas number two.
The key is always the quarterback. If you got your guy coming back, you don't have to break a new one in.
Kick goes out of bounds with a little over 2 minutes remaining in the ball game. Timeout, 2:19 remaining. 66-14 Texas. Drive summary, Texas, 9 scoring drives today. 5 of those, 3 plays or less. But they also had, 3 that went over 80 yards?
Yeah.
And they did it a variety of ways.
And the defense played well, and especially the special teams were there also.
Pass complete. Guys are still knocking heads out there. Pickup of 8, Marcus Griffin made the tackle. Marcus Griffin and Michael Griffin are twins. Yeah, that's Marcus, 26. Michael's a starter. He's 27. And Cedric Griffin, number 8, is not related. So there's a lot of Griffins back there.
A lot of Youngs also.
Mm-hmm.
Selvin, Vince, a couple other Youngs.
Throw complete out in the flat. Down the sideline, out of bounds. Jeff Foster with the reception. Yeah, everybody's thinking about roses. Vivo's got one right there on a strap on his nose. They think of everything, don't they?
I wonder what he's thinking.
He's thinking about grazing somewhere other than in the end zone.
Well, he was thinking that all those tailgaters now coming to the game, he doesn't want to join them.
Yeah, you don't want steaks cooked out there. You know, you say, I really had a great steak last night to Bevo, and he looks at you a little cross-eyed. Swanson still throwing, broken up. Intended for Dexter Fields. Well, we've got a second. We'll give you our Chevrolet players of the game today. I don't think there was a lot of doubt on the Texas side of things. Vince Young, career high 4 touchdown passes and leading his team to its 10th straight win of the regular season. John Cornish for Kansas. Nice job in the backfield for him today. In recognition of their effort, Chevrolet will make a $1,000 contribution to each university's general scholarship fund. Everybody can smile on the sideline in one like this. 66 points, the most since 1977. And a penalty marker on the play. And that's kind of how things started going for Kansas early.
I'll start. 65 offense, 5 yards, second down.
They had a few of those early in the ball game when they had some decent field position. Took them out of their game, and then Texas did the rest of the taking.
Yeah, they just need to regroup. And I think Mark Mangino, I think the way they came out and started the second half was great. And he'll take this group back and he'll say, listen, Texas is a class team. They're way above us. They're probably going to be playing for the national championship. Let's get back together and let's beat Iowa State this coming week and get in a bowl game.
Marcus Herford, another reception. Keeps his Kansas drive going in the final minute, 20 seconds.
I remember Mark being so much fun when he was with Oklahoma, the offensive coordinator of those championship years, he was fun to be with, and glad to get an opportunity to be a head coach, and he's done well. He just needs to get a few more players. I thought their defense coming into this ball game was quality. They just ran into a powerhouse in this offense on the road.
No doubt. Throw down middle, complete. Foster again, down to the 20. Kansas not quitting, down to the final seconds. 26-yard pass play. And the clock stopped as they move the chains. Down to the, just outside the 20. Well, Mack will win his 80th game here. And for the first time since 1983, a perfect 10-0 start. They keep playing like this, there'll be more than 10. 11 or 12 or 13. Throw in the corner, close, incomplete. Herford was the intended receiver. So Texas, after getting a scare from Kansas a year ago on the road, no problem here today at home. And Mack Brown now in his stay at Texas will be 43-3 on this field. This is the winningest group of seniors in Texas football history. 31 of them out here for the final time in the final half minute right now. There's a slip screen after Herford. Herford brought down as he gets inside the 15-yard line. Set to David Thomas, senior tight end. We had an exceptional day today. I said to him yesterday, what kind of emotions are you going to have on the field for your last game at Texas Memorial Stadium? He said, I'm trying not to think about it. I just got to think about the game because I don't want it to get in the way of the ball game. And Mack Brown said, You guys, if you want to cry, cry after the game. Don't cry before the game, because if you lose the game, you're going to be crying twice.
Yeah.
So that's at the point I said to David and the rest of the guys who were standing around us. I said, you know what? I got a feeling that if you guys go on and win the rest of your games, they'll probably have a little party on this field for you early in January.
That's
and
true.
That brought a smile to their face.
Oh, yeah. Of course, David was very excited. We asked him also about his best moment off the field here in Texas. He said the fact that he got engaged.
Yeah, got engaged. In
Cassidy, I think is her name.
Cassidy?
Yeah.
Yep.
So he's getting married in June.
Yeah. He got a lot of oohs and ahs from his teammates when he said that. Kinesiology major, he's one of you say, who's the smartest guy on the team? They all point to him. And he goes, you know, my dad was a math wizard. He thinks this stuff comes easy for me. But the calculus is a little tough.
He said his dad knew his test scores before he did.
Yeah, that's right, that's right. Well, they'll have a big time in the old town of Austin tonight. This is a fun town to have fun in, I'll tell you that much. Third down at four, and now they whistle the play dead.
Timeout. Texas.
Texas takes the timeout.
Timeout. A 30-second timeout.
Tonight, coming up, it was a late game and a late start. I think most of them started last night.
And it's 66-14. And both sides just take the timeout.
Yeah, there's a little gamesmanship going on right now. And Texas might bring a blitz into the championship.
Yep.
Swanson into the end zone, incomplete. That stops the clock with 14 seconds left.
You know, only because I've been there, I know what the feeling is down there on the field. Because the coaching staff, the players, they want to score if you're in the blue, and they don't want you to score if you're in the burnt orange.
Right, right.
And I don't care what the score is. The first string defensive players who are not out there don't want the backups to allow them to score.
There's a whole bunch of pride going on.
Exactly, and that's the way it should be.
Play it to the end. This might be the end for Kansas. Fourth down. Watson. Watson. Tips. Bring up. Texas will take over. There, Jackson got a hand on it. And that'll be the last gasp for the Jayhawks.
You come into this game against UCLA, who are you going to worry about? Drew Olson's been having a fantastic senior season, and you're going to be worried about Maurice Drew. And all of a sudden, boom, Drew Olson comes out on the floor. Look at this right here. Already all-time leader in season touchdown passes for UCLA, Drew Olson.
Head coach will let him know that.
Aaron Richardson,
5 yards
deep. Going to let it go out of the end zone. So Arizona State
will start first and 10 from their own 20.
Texas,
you talked about him already. Now Rudy Carpenter's got to answer what Olson just did. The redshirt freshman
weekend
from nearby Westlake, California. Westlake High School was recruited by UCLA, went to Arizona State. Look at those
State
numbers.
Tonight.
10 touchdowns,
resounding
2
victory for the Longhorns.
2-0 as a starter, and almost 74%.
That's the big key, Terry, down here. 2-0 as a starter this year already for the Bruins.
They jumped over
which
one today.
Great, but you already
they
put them in a
pretty
tough situation.
You're
already coming against a tough UCLA team.
Career high for
Mitchell,
four touchdowns.